welcome to the 12th lecture of module 5. In this module, we are discussing distillation. Let us have a recap of our previous lecture on this topic. In our previous lecture, we have primarily considered the design of a distillation column by Ponchon and Savarit method. Ponchon Savarit method primarily we have discussed for a fractionator what is the balance equations for the rectifying section. Stripping section and feed line. All the balance equations we have derived, and we know how to construct the HXY diagram. That is enthalpy concentration diagram. So, we will continue our previous lecture with how to determine the number of stages, required for a given separation. Using enthalpy concentration diagram, and in this case the main thing is that, as we said earlier, we assume the constant molar overflow in case of McCabe-Thiele method, but in case of Ponchon and Savarit we need the enthalpy data for different compositions, and we need not to assume the constant molar overflow rate. In this case we know the equilibrium data, x y data, and we know the H enthalpy of the liquid and enthalpy of the vapor, and so we can plot the lower curve represents H L x and this is H G y. First we will consider number of plates using HXY diagram. Here first we have to draw HXY diagram with the help of given data, which is plotted over here. This is H L x and this is H G y. Then we have to locate the points D and V dash, which is over here. This is point D and this is point V dash, and we know how to calculate the enthalpy at point V dash, whose concentration at this point is Z D. Then locate the feed point, which is F, is ZF and HF, which is located over here. Now join v dash f and extent to m dash, the point m dash which is based on the bottom compositions which is x w at point m, and the concentration is x w. You can draw a perpendicular line at point m downwards, and then we can extend the line v dash f to m dash. Then construct the stages, construct stages starting from v dash or m dash. A changeover has to be made at the fit point at these locations f, and we have to proceed the construction till the end point is reached. For this case, if we use only the enthalpy concentration diagram to find out the number of plates required for a given separation, we need to have the equations for the tie line. If tie lines are not available, it will be easier to handle with the use of the xy diagram in conjunction with the hxy diagram. Now, let us see how to obtain the number of plates using hxy and xy diagram. So, first we have to draw the xy diagram below hxy diagram with the similar scale, and then locate xw, xw and xd, xd on the diagonal. Which is located over here and another point is located over here. So, on the diagram the point xw, xw and xd, xd. So, these points are located, and then as we know from the earlier derivations, q v dash minus h l n divided by x d minus x n is equal to q v dash minus h g n plus 1 divided by x d minus y n plus 1. So, that any line which is emitted from point v dash or point m dash intersects the h x and h y curves at x n and y n plus 1. This is the points x n and y n plus 1 is the point on the operating line. If we draw several lines starting from at point V, and if we draw the line starting from x d and x d, and we obtain several points on the operating lines, and we could join all these points and we will obtain the operating line for the enriching section. This is the operating line for enriching section. Similarly, if we start drawing different lines from point M dash, in a similar procedure we could obtain operating line for the stripping section. This is the operating line for the stripping section. From the two different curves h x and h y, we can obtain the equilibrium curve which is given below. We know the equilibrium curve, we know the operating line for the different sections, and we know the fit point. If fit conditions is known to us, we can draw the fit line, and then similar procedure as we followed like McKeith-Thiele, we could follow the same procedure, that is staircase constructions of the stages, and we could obtain the number of stages required for the given separation. Now, using Punchen and Savarit method, we could obtain the minimum reflux ratio. To obtain the minimum reflux ratio, which is R min, we need to obtain the pinch point. First, to get a pinch point, to obtain the pinch point, if a line through V dash or M dash coincides with the tie line, then the value of x y gives the pinch point. We know the reflux ratio equations, R is equal to L naught by D is equal to Q dash V minus H G 1 divided by H G 1 minus H D, which is equal to vertical distance G 1 V dash divided by vertical distance D G 1. If V dash is nearer to G 1 or the distance G 1 V dash is as small, it increases the number of plates required or the reflux ratio is smaller. G 1 V dash, smaller reflux ratio. So, in many cases, V dash, M dash line coincides with tie line through the fit point. In some situations where for highly non-ideal mixtures, the tie line through a point other than fit point intersects the vertical line through x d at a smallest distance. This gives the true pinch point. As soon as the pinch point is obtained, then the same can be calculated using the equations described earlier. Using this same equations, we can use to obtain the minimum reflux ratio. Now, we will discuss the total reflux. At total reflux, the point V dash and M dash, these two points will be at infinity. These two points will be M dash and V dash will be at infinity. The line which will join between M dash and V dash will be a vertical line. So, all the lines between M dash and V dash will be the vertical line. So, V dash and M dash will be vertical lines. So, draw alternate tie lines starting from G1 to obtain the number of plates required at total reflux. So, at total reflux, the number of plates will be minimum. Now, it will be easy if we use the XY diagram instead of the enthalpy concentration diagram. Like we have done before, we can draw the XY curve using the HX and HY data, which is plotted over here. The operating lines for rectifying section and stripping section will coincide with the 45-degree diagonal, and the number of plates can be obtained by staircase construction between diagonal and equilibrium line, which is shown over here. Start at the point of XD, this is the point of XD. So, locate this point, this is the fit point ZF and this is XW. So, these points are located and then we know the equilibrium curve. So, join them, this is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, this is the number of plates at total reflux. Now, what is the optimum reflux ratio? When we design a new column, we need to use a optimum reflux ratio. As we increase the reflux ratio, increased reflux ratio, what happens? It decreases the number of plates. Decreases number of plates required. So, the column height decreases. On the other hand, what happens? Liquid and vapor flow rates increases. So, it increases the column diameter and overall decreases the cost of column. This is the fixed cost. Another thing is that as we increase the reflux ratio, increases the heat duty, increases heat duty for reboiler and condenser. So, the size and capital cost increases, also higher operating costs. So, overall if we plot cost versus reflux ratio, there will be a minimum reflux ratio, which is R min, and the operating cost would gradually increase as we increase the reflux ratio. This is operating cost and the fixed cost initially will be higher and then it decreases and then it increases. So, this is a fixed cost. So, the total cost will increase and so there will be a minima of the total cost curve. So, this will give the optimum or optimum, that is optimum reflux ratio. for the operations. This is in general 1.2 to 1.5 times of Rm or mean. Let us take an example for calculations of the number of plates using Punchon and Savarid method. A feed containing 50 mole% A and 50 mole% B is fed to a distillation column. A reflux ratio of 1.3 is maintained. The overhead product is 96% A and the bottom is 5% A. Find the number of theoretical stages. Assume that a total condenser is used. The column is to operate at 1 atmosphere. Equilibrium data is given below. So, this represents mole fractions of component A, that is X A, and this is for saturated liquid enthalpy in terms of kilocalorie per kilomole, and this is saturated liquid and this is saturated vapor. With help of this data, we can plot the equilibrium curve and we can plot the HXY diagram. H X H L X and H L Y, these are the two plots and the points which is given feed points, and this is the bottom composition and this is the X D which is located over here is given. So, these points are located. And now, we can plot the operating line between the enriching section. So, we have located the point V dash, given that X W is equal to 0.05 and X F is 0.5 and X D is 0.96. So, these points are located. This is at 0.96, this is X W which is 0.05 and this is the feed point is 0.5. Now, from the table we can see the enthalpy of the distillate H D is given 2900 kilocalorie per k mole and Y 1 is 0.96, H G 1 is 10,200 corresponding to this, and then the reflux ratio is given, R is equal to 1.3. Now, if we use R is equal to Q V dash minus H G 1 divided by H G 1 minus H D. So, it will be 1.3 would be equal to Q V dash minus 10,200 divided by 10,200 minus 2900. So, from this you can obtain Q V dash is equal to 19,690, which is located over here V dash, which is the value at 0.96 and 19,690. So, this is the point which is located V dash. Now, the overall enthalpy lines, we can draw the lines from point B dash to M dash and which will intersect the point at F, feed point F, which is Z F is equal to 0.5, and then the point G 1 which is over here G 1 will lie on the saturated vapor curve at x is equal to x d, since total condenser is used. Now, we can draw operating lines on the x y diagram. Operating lines are drawn between these two sections, and then the construction was followed from these points over here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total number of plates is equal to 6 with a partial reboiler. The total number of trays is equal to 6 minus 1 is equal to 5, and the optimum fit tray location is equal to, we can see, which is the saturated liquid, which is over here, plate number 2, this way we can obtain the number of ideal stages required and locate the fit tray. Now, we will discuss distillation in packed column. In some cases where packed column distillation is preferred, particularly in case of low capacity applications or low pressure or vacuum applications and corrosive services. And the tower used for this packed column distillation is essentially similar to the one which we have used for gas absorption, which we have discussed before, but with a little modifications. And this tower is particularly modified with a distributor for the feed, a condenser, a reflux drum, and a reboiler. In this case, we have to determine the height of packing required for a given separation. How to determine that? Two general methods generally employed. One is the height and number of transfer unit method, which is HTG or NTG method, and then HETP method. HETP is height equivalent to a theoretical plate. Height equivalent to a theoretical plate method is essentially similar, which we have discussed for packed tower absorptions. Now, we will discuss height and number of transfer unit method. This is a typical packed distillation column, where feed enters at a particular location with a composition ZF, and we have a reflux drum and then distillate. Here is a condenser, and similarly at the bottoms we have a partial reboiler as in distillation. Let us consider the rectifying section, how to do the balance. For the rectifying section, we have the following assumptions: constant molar overflow, liquid and gas flow rate G and L respectively, liquid and gas phase mass transfer coefficient small k x dash and k y dash, specific interfacial area A, and local flux at a particular height Z from bottom of the packed section is N A. Now, total interfacial surface would be A d Z. So, we have taken a differential section of thickness d Z. So, the total interfacial surface would be A interfacial area into d Z, and the vapor component which is passing through this differential section would be d G y. Similarly, the liquid which is passing through this differential section would be dLx. So, if we do the differential mass balance for the vapor phase, it would be A dz Na would be d of g into y. So, we will get k y dash A y I minus y dz is equal to g dy, where y I is the interfacial concentrations. Similarly, for the liquid phase, we can obtain k x dash A into x minus x I dz is equal to L dx. If we take this vapor phase equations and rearrange and integrate over the rectifying section from 0 to z r, we consider the height of the rectifying section is z r, then this z r, if we integrate, would be g by k dash y A integral y f to y 2 d y divided by y I minus y. So, this is known as NTG integral term, and this term, first term is HTG. The first term is height of transfer unit, and this can be calculated if k y dash A is known, and NTG can be calculated by graphical integration if we know the interfacial concentration y I. For a set of values of y, we can get interfacial concentration y I, and then we can do the numerical integrations. Now, how to get this interfacial concentration for a set of values of y? If we consider the vapor phase and the liquid phase, these two relations, and if we divide these two relations, we will have the ratio of mass transfer coefficients. We know the equation of operating line for rectifying section for a given r, and we can take a point x y on the operating line and draw a line with the slope of k x dash A divided by k y dash A. So, if we draw this line, will meet in the equilibrium line at point x I and y I, and if the individual coefficient remains constant over that section, these lines from different points on the operating line, they will be parallel line. So, for a set of points x y corresponding interfacial concentration x I and y I can be obtained, which can be used for the integration. Similar design equations can be written for height and number of transfer units in the liquid phase, where we can calculate z r would be h t l into n t l, height of transfer unit in the liquid phase and number of transfer unit in the liquid phase. Now, we know that from the differential mass balance A d z n a is equal to g into d y. So, if we write in terms of the overall mass transfer coefficient, overall gas phase mass transfer coefficient, k y dash into y star minus y, y star is the equilibrium concentrations, then we can write z would be equal to h t o g. H t o g is nothing but g by capital K y dash A gas flow rate divided by overall gas phase mass transfer coefficient. Similarly, z can be obtained based on the overall mass transfer coefficient in the liquid phase, which is given over here. The values of y star for a set of values of y can be obtained from operating line and equilibrium line, as we discussed before. Now, numbers of overall gas phase or liquid phase transfer unit are then be determined by graphical integration. A similar procedure is used to determine the packing height for the stripping section. So far, we have discussed the design procedure, how to obtain the packing height in the rectifying section. Similar procedure should be adopted to obtain the height of packing in the stripping section, so that the total height required for a given separation can be obtained. Thank you.